Hey guys, today I'll be taking a look at the extremely competitive Senate and gubernatorial elections in the state of Wisconsin. Joe Biden only barely won the state by 0.6% in the 2020 presidential election, and so for a very long time, most people believed that Republicans were going to pretty easily win both races in the state. However, at this point in time, Democrats have a very good shot at flipping the Wisconsin Senate seat with Ron Johnson as the Republican incumbent. Mandela Barnes has a 49% chance at winning the election. Wisconsin, according to 538 right now, is the most competitive Senate election that we have this year. And on the gubernatorial level, Democratic incumbent Governor Tony Evers has a 67% chance at winning his second term in office against Tim Michels. And so starting off with the Senate election, if Democrats can actually defeat Ron Johnson, their odds at maintaining a Senate majority go up drastically. So with a win in Wisconsin, Democrats are also probably going to flip Pennsylvania. John Fetterman is in a much better position in that election against Mehmet Oz. And so Democrats also have incumbents in Nevada, Arizona, and Georgia. But if Democrats can win these two Midwestern races, they will only have to hold on to one out of these three remaining seats. And so Mark Kelly right now has a 76% chance at winning a second term in office. And so this will already give Democrats the 50 seats that they need. If Republicans lose in Wisconsin, their odds at winning back control of the upper chamber basically disappear. If you look at this new 538 page, it shows you the odds for both parties of winning a majority. I have basically only left the six toss-up races out, so these six races are not called, but with all the other races filled in, Democrats currently have a 73% chance at winning a majority in the Senate for a second time in a row. If Democrats can flip Wisconsin, their odds go all the way up to 92%. And then, of course, with Pennsylvania, they will have a 97% chance at maintaining control of the U.S. Senate for another 2 years. According to the Politico forecast, Democrats and Republicans both have a very good chance at winning the Senate as it remains a toss-up. Even though odds are going for Democrats overall, you cannot count out the GOP. They are out of power in the White House, out of power in both chambers of Congress. It would only be natural for them to win something back this November. And if you look at the race in Wisconsin specifically, it is one of the four toss-up races alongside Pennsylvania, Georgia, and Nevada. And so this forecast uses four data categories to rate each election. The four categories are incumbency, fundraising, candidate quality, and long-term trends. And so right now, Republicans are obviously favored in the incumbency category as they are running the incumbent senator. However, in the three categories of fundraising, candidate quality, and long-term trends, no party has any clear advantage. However, I would argue, though, personally, that Republicans are favored in the long-term trends in Wisconsin. Wisconsin used to be a pretty Democratic state. It voted for Democratic presidential candidates for 28 years in a row. In 2016, yes, Trump did win in Wisconsin, but before that, last time a Republican won a presidential election in the state was all the way back in 1984 when Walter Mondale won 49 out of the 50 states in the Union. And so after this, in every single election, Democrats did hold on to the state of Wisconsin. And of course, in 2020, Joe Biden won back the state, but by a very small margin. So Democrats do not have the grip on Wisconsin as they once did. The last time Democrats won Wisconsin by double digits was all the way back in 2008 when Obama won the state by 14% against John McCain. So looking at the overall trends here, it definitely does favor the Republican Party. But that does not mean that Democrats are counted out. Wisconsin is still a very purple state. And to say that Democrats control a Senate seat in right now, the other seat currently held by Tammy Baldwin, and also they control the governorship. So Republicans do not have an advantage in the state. But if you look at long-term trends, the state is shifting to the right, just like many other states in the Midwest, states like Michigan, Pennsylvania, and especially Iowa and Ohio. If we look at Joe Biden's popularity in Wisconsin, his approval rating, I think, provides one of the best pieces of good news for Democrats this midterm. Joe Biden's unpopularity is not having as large of an impact on the midterms as Republicans would have liked to hope. Donald Trump was very unpopular in 2018, and so Democrats flipped over 40 seats in the House just 2 years later. But in 2022, Republicans are probably not going to do the same thing with Joe Biden in office. If you look at Joe Biden's popularity right now in Wisconsin, even though he has a 53% disapproval rating, Mandela Barnes still has a 49% chance at winning the election. And so Civics is known for skewing numbers against whoever the approval poll is for. These are online polls, so respondents are more inclined to vote against the candidate that the approval poll is for. So Joe Biden's numbers in reality are probably a tiny bit better, but he is still very much disapproved of as a whole in a state that he won in 2020. If you look at the overall map, Joe Biden really is not doing too well in any state that he won in the previous presidential election. However, I mean, Democrats still have a very good chance in many Senate elections in states like Nevada, Arizona, Georgia, or Pennsylvania. So his unpopularity is, like I said before, not having the desired impact that Republicans would like. And on top of that, Joe Biden's numbers are actually going up. As as we enter just 2 months until the midterms in November. Joe Biden's approval rating currently sits at 43%. His net approval has dropped under negative 10%, and that does mean that Joe Biden is now actually helping Democrats overall compared to where he was just a couple of months ago. And so enough with the Senate election. We also have a major gubernatorial race in Wisconsin. Tony Evers is the Democratic incumbent running for re-election. Tim Michaels is the GOP nominee, won his race a couple of weeks ago against former Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Clefish. Tim Michaels did receive the endorsement of Donald Trump, but compared to many other Republican candidates that they're putting up for governor elections, Tim Michaels is much more moderate. I mean, we have Kerry Lake in Arizona, we have Joe Lombardo in Nevada, and then Doug Mastrodon in Pennsylvania. In Wisconsin, Tim Michaels is much more moderate of a right-wing candidate, and so that's what makes him such a good candidate. I think Tim Michaels has the opportunity to defeat Tony Evers, but it is still going to be a very close race no matter who wins this election. In 2018, Tony Evers defeated incumbent Scott Walker, who was running for a third term. I mean, that was a pretty big deal. Most governors do not run for a third time, and Scott Walker was actually recalled. He survived that recall by a pretty strong margin, so this was actually Scott Walker's fourth election for the governorship of Wisconsin. Tony Evers defeating him was a pretty big deal, and the polls at the very end did show a very close race. Evers' 1.1% margin in the very end did match up very much with the polling average. And so right now, Tony Evers leads by a very similar margin in the polls, 1% against Tim Michaels overall, according to the 538 average. If you look at every single poll released for this race, you will see Tony Evers leading. Evers actually leads by 1% according to the most recent Trafalgar Group poll. This is the same poll that showed Mandela Barnes up by 2. So both Democratic candidates are doing well in Wisconsin, at least according to the most right-wing pollster in the country. But of course, this could be an anomaly due to the sample that they chose. I do think Tim Michaels cannot be counted out in this election. He is overall a much better candidate than many other Republican nominees we're seeing this year, and Tony Evers is very, very vulnerable. The last time that a Democratic gubernatorial candidate in Wisconsin won a governor election with a Democratic president in the White House was all the way back in 1962 when John F. Kennedy was still in office. But despite this, the 538 forecast currently has Wisconsin as a lean Democratic state, with Tony Evers having a 2-in-3 chance at winning re-election. I think this is just a bit too high for Democrats. If Tony Evers wins, it's going to be by a very similar margin to the one that he had in 2018. Tony Evers is not going to win by the 3 points that 538 currently projects. Wisconsin is going to be ultra-competitive, especially considering the fact that in 2018, the national environment was very much better for the Democrats overall. They were up by 8.6% 4 years ago. Now they're only up by a margin of 0.9%. So just off of that, Democrats are not going to be in as strong of a position in the Wisconsin race. Wisconsin is a very purple state and very capable of flipping to the GOP. If you look at the 2016 election, of course, Donald Trump flipped Iowa, Ohio, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania, and almost won Minnesota. Clinton only carried it by 1.5%. But if you look at the 2018 midterm map for the governor elections, Democrats really did do very, very well. We had some pretty close elections in Iowa and Ohio. Mike DeWine and Kim Reynolds barely won their first terms, and in Minnesota and almost Michigan, Democrats won by double-digit margins. Pennsylvania was solid for Tom Wolf when he ran for a second term. And of course, in Wisconsin, we had one of the major flips for Democrats in 2018. So the Midwest voted very much in favor of the Democratic Party 4 years ago, and that is not going to happen this time around. These gubernatorial candidates are going to campaign like crazy if they want to win, especially Tony Evers. He is the weakest out of all four Democrats, just based on the partisanship of his state. Politico currently has Wisconsin as a toss-up election, just like the Senate race, and overall they do believe more Americans will be led by Democratic governors, even though Democrats are less likely to win a majority of governorships in terms of the sheer numbers. Republicans are still probably going to control more governorships just because they have a lot of governors in many of these very small states that Democrats do not have. And the last time that Democrats won more governorships than Republicans in a major midterm year was all the way back in 2006 when they won 28. This was 6 years after the election of George W. Bush. You can understand why Democrats did so well, but after 2010, Republicans have always maintained more governorships. In 2014, Democrats only won 18 governorships. This was an abysmal showing for the party, and then they did win a few more in 2018, and then in 2021, they lost the Virginia governorship to Glenn Youngkin. So right now, Democrats only have 22 governorships. I don't think Democrats are going to lose too many this November, but still, they're not likely to gain over 25. And if you look at the Wisconsin race right now, specifically according to this forecast, it is one of the five toss-up elections alongside Arizona, Nevada, Georgia, and Kansas. So in Wisconsin, we see a very similar story to the Senate election. No party has a major advantage in the three lower factors here, but in terms of incumbency, Democrats are favored, obviously simply because they're running the incumbent governor. And so the final thing I want to look at in this video is that Trafalgar Group poll that I've been mentioning, the one that showed Democrats ahead in both the Senate and governor elections. This was the same poll with the same 1,091 likely voters responding. And so the Trafalgar Group is known for being pretty much the largest and most well-known Republican pollster in the country. They almost always skew their numbers in favor of the GOP. Their polling data always has Republicans doing better than the overall average. And in some cases, the Trafalgar Group is known for being pretty accurate, especially in presidential elections. They are pretty accurate in states like North Carolina and Florida in 2020, and they did show races being much closer than the average in many of the key Midwestern races in states like Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania, even though they were overall still inaccurate. So if you look at the Trafalgar polls, they almost always skew their numbers in favor of Republicans, and that's why it's such a big deal that Democrats are leading in both of the polls that they had for the Wisconsin races. So looking at the Senate poll, this was a pretty short poll, only two questions. They asked voters who they would vote for in the Senate election. 49.4% of respondents said they would vote for Manella Barnes. 47.1% said they would vote for Ron Johnson, the incumbent Republican. So obviously, these numbers should be worrying for the GOP. If you look at the gubernatorial poll here, they show Tony Evers at 48% and Tim Michaels at 47.5%. So the governor election is much closer. I think that Ron Johnson is just not that great of a candidate. He is very unpopular in the state of Wisconsin, and that's one of the major reasons why Manella Barnes has such a good chance. I think that Manella Barnes has a better chance at flipping the Senate seat in Wisconsin right now than Tony Evers does at winning re-election to the governorship. That's just how poor of a candidate Ron Johnson is, even though he's probably one of the best Republicans they could have chosen. So Tony Evers at 48%, Michaels at just 47.5. This is a Trafalgar poll, though, so you have to remember that these numbers are probably skewed in favor of Republicans, but this should be a bit worrying for the Evers campaign, especially considering the fact that he is underperforming Manella Barnes in a Senate seat currently held by a Republican incumbent. And if you look at the party participation in this poll, you'll see Republicans at 45.4% of those who responded, 43.2% were Democrats. So more Republicans responded to this poll than Democrats. And even despite this, Democrats were leading in both races. And so, yes, of course, the Trafalgar Group is known for oversampling Republicans. But it is also true that Republicans do turn out more in midterm races. But with Roe v. Wade being overturned, I think energy among Democrats, especially female Democratic voters, will be much higher. And of course, females do go to the polls more than males, as history has shown. And so that'll be it for this analysis of both Wisconsin elections. If you want me to make a final prediction for right now, I do think Wisconsin will still go red on the Senate level. I think that Ron Johnson can win his re-election. He was expected to lose in 2016. He still did pull off a win. 2022 Republicans are in a better position nationwide. I think that he can defeat Manella Barnes, but really what's going to matter the most is what happens in the next 2 months. The month of October especially is going to be defining for these two races. I think Democrats can still win, but as of right now, I have Ron Johnson winning by around 1-3%, so a very slight advantage for the GOP. And in the gubernatorial election, I think Tim Michaels does have a shot. I'm going to put Wisconsin as a tilt Republican state. Yes, Tony Evers is the incumbent, but you have to remember 2022, not like 2018, and Wisconsin is a very purple state with, I think, a slightly Republican-leaning partisanship. So as of right now, Wisconsin I have as tilt Republican. I think Tony Evers can still definitely pull this race back, but with just a 1% margin in the polls, it simply is not enough for me to give the race to Tony Evers right now. And of course, Joe Biden was highly overestimated in polling leading up to the 2020 election in Wisconsin. So right now, I do have Republicans winning both races if I had to make just one projection, but I do think that both these races can be classified as toss-ups, and what will really matter is what happens in the next 2 months leading up to the midterms in November. And so that'll be it for this video. Make sure you like it down below. If you enjoyed it, comment down below which party you think will win more Senate seats. Do you think Democrats will win Wisconsin? Which party do you think will win more governorships? Do you think Democrats will be able to hold on to the Wisconsin governorship with Tony Evers running for re-election? Subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Consider purchasing a channel membership for just 99 cents per month. That will give you extra perks on this channel for the two remaining months leading up to, of course, the 2022 elections. And I'll see you guys in the next video.